In this video, you can see that the price is making a V-shaped formation, which seems to be ideal for drawing a pitchfork. Therefore, by selecting three valid fractals, we start to draw a classic pitchfork. And according to the first law of Andrew's pitchfork, we wait for it to reach its median line. In its first attempt, price approaches the median line but cannot touch it and moves towards the upper parallel line. Price attempts to pass this line three times, but each time by forming a lower fractal shows that it is unable to cross this barrier. When the price is attracted several times by the upper or lower parallel line of the pitchfork like a magnet and fails to cross it, a strong trading signal is provided to us suggesting that the price is most likely to move sharply in the opposite direction towards the median line, like what happened here. After the price reaches the median line, it struggles with it for a while. But the point to note is that the price is building a harmonic pattern on the median line, which is called bullish tree drive. We will talk in detail about the various harmonic patterns in separate series of videos, but in short, tree drive's pattern consists of three consecutive price movements, each ending in specific Fibonacci levels, and then the price will move in the opposite direction. Also, the divergence between the price and indicator increases the credibility of this pattern. And as you can see, in both successive attacks, there is a clear divergence between the price and indicator. When we put these pieces of evidence next to the second rule, which states that the price will most likely bounce back away from the median line, we can guess that there is a high probability that the price return in the opposite direction, something that finally happened. In the second law of the pitchfork, we explained that after reaching the median line, price could experience other situations in addition to bouncing back away from this line. For example, it can cross the median line by forming a gap or a marabuzu, which refers to a tall candle that does not have upper and lower shadows. Or it can swing around the median line and then moves toward one of the parallel lines of the pitchfork with the completion of its correction. However, with the advent of 24-hour financial markets, the appearance of price gaps around the median line is less common, but even that small number is worth considering. In the following, we will explain these situations with several practical examples. In this image, another type of pitchfork is drawn on the price charts, which is slightly different from the classic pitchfork that uses a fractal as the base point. In future videos, we will talk in detail about the different types of modern pitchforks and how to draw them on price charts, citing numerous examples. But in short, the base point of this pitchfork, which I call vertical midpoint or VM, can be drawn from the middle point of the vertical distance between two specific fractals on the chart. But the way to select the other two points is the same as what we do in the classic type. As you can see, the price first crosses the median line with an enormous gap, but in the end, it stops at the 50% Fibonacci level inside the pitchfork. And after several failures to cross this line, it forms a shape that is similar to the tree drive pattern mentioned in the previous example, and then swiftly moves toward its median line. When the price approaches the median line, we see the first price gap before reaching this line, which promises a strong breakout toward the upper parallel line. Then, after crossing this line, we see another price gap that ensures that the price continues to move toward the pitchfork ceiling. And as you can see, the price has hit the upper parallel line and returned. In this video, you can see that by selecting three valid fractals, we have drawn another type of pitchfork, which some trading platforms refer to it as an internal pitchfork. We will talk about how to draw this pitchfork in future videos, but many trading platforms will automatically provide this pitchfork for you by selecting three desired points on the chart. A closer look at the price movement around the median line of this pitchfork shows that the price is fluctuating around it. This in itself represents one of the pitchfork's rules. And we expect the price to move towards the upper parallel line after completing its correction, which is in the form of a descending triangle. Knowing this seemingly simple rule, you can immediately enter into a suitable buy position after breaking the upper side of the triangle and place your stop loss below the base of the triangle. And as we learned in the previous video, we estimate our exit point. And as you can see here, the price has reached its target. In this video, by selecting three valid fractals, we draw another type of pitchfork called shift pitchfork. In the next videos, we will get familiar with the steps of drawing it manually. But as with the inside pitchfork, some trading platforms automatically draw it for you. As can be seen here, price fails to cross the median line in its first attempt, but after bouncing back away from it, it stops at the 61.8% Fibonacci level inside the pitchfork. Finally, by completing a powerful candlestick pattern that is called Morningstar, it attacks the median line for one more time. After a brief correction, it manages to cross the median line with a Marubozu candle with a very tall body. By seeing this powerful candle, many traders will enter into a buy position. But others who are more conservative can wait and, based on the third law of the pitchfork, go long after the price touches the median line for the last time. In this case, by going to a lower time frame and finding valid fractals, they can place their entry and stop loss orders at the top and bottom of these points respectively. In the end, as you can see, price has hit the pitchfork ceiling and bounced back from it. Here, the price movement seems to be suitable for drawing a classic pitchfork, but ultimately the price is unable to reach its median line and returns to the upper parallel line. As we explained at the beginning of this video, the absorption of price by one of the parallel lines of a pitchfork before it reaches the median line and repeated testing of this line can be a sign of an explosive price movement toward the median line. But here, after knowing the Hagopian law, we can also add that the price can start moving with a much stronger momentum in the opposite direction after breaking the upper parallel line of the pitchfork. So we wait for one of these scenarios to happen and then enter into a buy or sell position based on that. After a short time, the price breaks through the upper parallel line with a strong candle, and as you can see, the hidden divergence between the price and indicator confirms this. After the price starts to move upwards, we plot another classic pitchfork so that we can use it to predict the future price movement. As can be seen, the price does not react well to the second classic pitchfork and leaves it. And because, as we mentioned earlier, the most important criterion for the validity of a pitchfork is the price reaction to it. Using the same fractals, we draw another type of pitchfork called modified shift. You got familiar with its simple type in the previous example. We will explain how to draw it manually in the future. Price shows two extremely suitable reactions to this pitchfork, and it promises that we can count on it to work properly in the future. As the price movement goes on, the pitchfork shows more efficiency, and then, after leaving the upper parallel line and before continuing its upward trend, it returns to it and touches it for the last time. So here we find out that the third rule of the pitchfork, in addition to the median line, can be applied to the parallel lines and even their images. In the next video, we will get familiar with other rules and also see how the images of pitchfork lines and their internal and external Fibonacci levels can affect the price movement. In the end, if this video was useful to you, please support us by pressing the like button. And don't forget to subscribe and press the bell button to be notified of new videos. Till next time.